Hi, it's Lisa Catalano, and today I'm going to talk about pseudo-elements. Pseudo-elements are a way to add actual content to your page using CSS only. Of course, in normal circumstances, you want your content to be found in the HTML, but there are plenty of use cases for pseudo-elements where you might want to add something to the page for presentational reasons. One example is in the drop-down navigation that I created in my last tutorial. If we look at the menu, there are two menus with drop-down submenus that are only displayed when you hover over the menu. There's nothing to indicate to the user that there are more options underneath. I'm starting with the code for my drop-down navigation example. I'm going to add a class name to any menu items with a submenu. I'll just call it sub. Now I can target those items with the class sub. If I add the colon colon after to the subselector, I'll be able to add some content after the selector. I do that by specifying content as the property, and then whatever I want to add as the value inside quotes. Whatever I type will get added after the selector that I'm targeting. This is not really what I want. If I open the developer tools and inspect the item, I do need to refresh the page so I can look without the live preview hooks in here. Now we can see this element, colon, colon, after, at the end of the li tags with the class of sub. It comes after the submenu, which is why we see it on a new line. We don't actually see the greater than symbol that I added. We see the element after. The greater than symbol comes from the CSS, which you can see when you look at the element styles. I really want this to be added at the end of the anchor tag, like this. You might wonder, why not just add it directly to the HTML? Well, of course you can do that, but if you have a really complex navigation that changes, it's easier to target all of the menus that need the character with a class name like sub, instead of having to update the HTML every time your menu structure changes. This content could be anything. It could be many characters or an image that you specify with a URL. I'd like this to be a triangle instead of a greater than symbol. We can use a character for that instead of an image. There's a nice website that shows you symbols that are available to use using character codes, graphemica.com. If I search for a right triangle, I have lots of options. I want to use this small right pointing triangle. It's telling me the Unicode character, but if I put that in the content, it won't work. It will just display those characters. We can see the HTML entity, but that doesn't work here either. We could use that if we were adding the content directly to the HTML, but if we used it here, it would just display the characters. Instead, if I scroll down and find the source code section, it tells me the way to represent this character in CSS. Basically, it's the same number from above, 25B8, with a slash 0 in front of it instead of the U plus. So if I make that the content, it works. We see a nice right triangle right there. One of the nice things about pseudo-elements is that they can be styled. I'd like to move the triangle over just a bit so I can add margin left of 3 pixels and the characters will have a little breathing room. I could change the color also if I wanted. I'd like to change the character to be pointing downward on hover. We could handle that by transforming the character with a rotate, or we could just find a downward facing triangle to set as the content. I'll search for down triangle and I can use this character. I want to target .sub colon hover, then a colon colon after, and I can assume the CSS version of this character is backslash 0 plus the characters I copied. Now when we hover, we can see the character change. I need to fix my selectors so the triangle only gets added to the top anchor tags. I can do that by adding the greater than symbol to my selector, so only anchor tags that are direct descendants of the subclass will be targeted. Now, I've been talking about after, but there's also a before pseudo-element, which, as you might guess, will add some content right before your element. It works exactly the same. I mentioned already that you can use an image for the content insert. I could add an image before my navigation items by specifying a URL for the content. I'm using the direct descendant selector again so I don't get the submenu items. I don't really want this image, but just wanted to demonstrate how that works. This technique could be used for navigational icons. So that's a quick look at pseudo-elements. You probably don't want to use them to insert real content into your websites, but for adding some presentational elements or decoration, they can be very useful. There are many interesting things that have been done using these elements, and you can find many examples all over the web. One of the most common uses is to use an after element as a clear fix solution when you're using floats. I've talked about that solution in a previous tutorial called Clear Fix Solution. If you have any questions, please let me know. Thanks for watching.